Hi everybody, I am Brian Mullins the Fox, back again but with a different research video series entirely. Let's entertain an alternate timeline when it comes to the roast game having hypothetically never happened at all, even though it really did in reality. This is part one, known as Child Population Differences in Both Countries, the United States of America and Canada. All of this, of course, stems from the roast game population bottleneck theory that was proven to be valid on February 14th, 2024, when it was uploaded. Quick recap of methodology as referenced before. Number one, for the US, when it comes to the total child population for each year, multiply the number of total children by 0.06 or 6%. Two, then subtract that by 4,645,000 and find what the total number for each year is. And finally, number three, after subtracting the negative numbers, subtract 4,645,000 by the other number you got from subtracting said negative numbers and find out. If it's a negative number, that means even if the roast game never happened at all, which it did by the way, the numbers don't add up to the contrary of the claim that is made saying that it did indeed happen. In the end, if the total number I get is higher than 977,280, or the yearly roast game death toll in America during the roast game era on average, then it proves that the roast game happened, or the exact opposite of what this hypothetical was supposed to prove. If the total number I get is lower than 977,280, then it's back to the drawing board. Without further ado, let's get cracking. 1998, negative 360. 1999, negative 331,000. 2000, negative 301,000. 2001, negative 283,000. 2002, negative 271,000. 2003, negative 259,000. 2004, negative 247,000. 2005, negative 235,000. 2006, negative 217,000. 2007, negative 205,000. 2008, negative 199,000. 2009, negative 199,000. 2010, negative 199,000. 2011, negative 211,000. 2012, negative 223,000. 2013, negative 229,000. 2014, negative 229,000. 2015, negative 223,000. And for 2016, negative 223,000. Let's see what we get when we subtract all these negative numbers together. And we get 3,465,000. Wow, a big number, but we're not done yet for the US. Let's subtract 4,645,000 by 3,465,000. Then we get 1,180,000. Meaning that since it is higher than 977,280, it proves that the roast game happened. Given that the video I made back in 2019 proving the roast game death toll initially and statistically as a part of a short-lived miniseries known as Bashing the Religious, showing that the number before I counted off all the other causes of death than the roast game's 977,280, it was about 2.2 million. I can easily discard the 1,180,000 number now and replace it with a 977,280 number. Now let's move on to Canada. Now, the methodology for Canada is completely different and also stems from the roast game population bottleneck theory. Disregard the previously mentioned methodology from said video because I made it a little better. Step 1, add up all the numbers for each represented year in the Canadian child population. Step 2, divide the total number of Canadian children combined from 1998 to 2016 and see whether or not the average number is higher or lower than the average between 2000 and 2016, meaning that at this point, I'm trying to find the rate that children in Canada were being slaughtered for not believing in Christmas from 1998 to 1999 in comparison to the 54.1% from 2000 to 2016. If it's lower than the average between 2000 and 2016, then it shows that the average population decreased even when the average total child population is different. If it's higher than the average between 2000 and 2016, rate-wise, or total number-wise, then it would mean that it made no difference between 1998 and 2016, meaning that it would mean that it quote-unquote never happened, even though it did. Step 3. Determine which conclusion is accurate by comparing the yearly Canadian roast game death toll with the average hypothetical number, or measure the percentage to find the rate of which children were being slaughtered in. And finally, step 4, subtract the difference between the average total child population in Canada from 1998 to 2016 by the averaged child population by multiplying it by 54.1% and see whether or not if the total number is higher than the yearly Canadian roast game death toll or lower. If it's higher, just like in the US, then the yearly Canadian roast game death toll, it would only mean that the roast game happened in Canada, therefore the number that is higher than the yearly Canadian roast game death toll can also be rejected and discarded and replaced with the Canadian roast game yearly death toll itself. Without further ado, let's get cracking again. According to theglobaleconomy.com, the average percentage of children between the ages of 0 and 14 is 22.27 as of 2022. So for 1998 and 1999, it'll be different from 2000 to 2016. Let's start. 1998, 6,713,250. 1999, 6,770,031. 2000, 9,463,510. 2001, 9,715,760. 2002, 9,917,250. 2003, 9,812,790. 2004, 9,851,240. 2005, 9,642,830. 2006, 9,705,020. 2007, 9,714,070. 2008, 9,745,740. 2009, 9,784,200. 2010, 9,822,380. 2011, 9,875,150. 2012, 9,930,830. 2013, 9,981,970. 2014, 10,041,850. 2015, 10,106,450. And finally, 2016, 10,184,570. In conclusion, it's lower than 54.1%. It's 45.1%. That means that from 1998 to 1999, the initial rate that children were being slaughtered for not believing in Christmas in was 9%, but increased dramatically at an average of 54.1% from 2000 to 2016. So, in mathematical summary, 5,433,410 minus 4,529,675, which by the way, I have to divide by 19 because the post-roast game era in Canada began in 2017, by the Christmas of 2017, equals 903,735. Meaning that the Canadian roast game happened, proving the yearly Canadian roast game death toll. Now, I can discard the 5,433,410 number. And also, the 903,735 number is meaningless and can be discarded as well because it's excess of another meaningless number. It would have been the worst case scenario for me if the results I came up with objectively by using math were to be the opposite case, or the total average number being lower instead of higher, like it should be, if and when the roast game happens at all in both countries, in both cases for the US and Canada, as demonstrated in this video. So there you have it. That completes the first out of four episodes of this amazing series so far. Tune in next time where we go into the deets of hypothetical consumption stats, Christmas dinner prices, and why any hypothetical alternate timeline, other than that in which shows and proves that the roast game happened at all in both countries, can just be discarded and ignored, which makes my job a hell of a lot easier. Thank you all so much for watching. I am your host, Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out. Goodbye.